In this video, we're briefly going to talk about what type of content you can share and some of the best practices to do when you are sharing your content in iTunes U. So I've logged into the course manager, and I'm going to go to my Digital First Example course by clicking on it, and I'm going to click on Materials. Here are all the materials I've uploaded to this course so far. Many of them are links to YouTube clips or videos or a PDF. Notice I have a running list going of different types of things I've added. There's audio, video, I could add an iBook, documents would be anything being a PowerPoint to a Word document to a PDF, apps from the App Store, you can upload photos, and again, links to videos that I have on the internet. If I click back on my hat, Apple has released a really good document about what types of materials you can add and sort of walks you through that process. If I click on it, this is what the document is. It talks about what media is supported, audio, video, and it tells you what type of files work the best and what would be the most appropriate to upload. For example, in books, you could provide access to an EPUB book or an iBook so that students can access either. Note that iBooks are only accessible on iOS devices, for example, an iPad or an iPhone. Again, documents, you can upload a lot of stuff for different types of documents, and it's a really good document to understand what you should upload. Also, when you're uploading your content, you should really pay attention to your copyright. If you've created the content, for example, your video or a photo you've taken and you upload it, you own that content. You own the intellectual property. But if you are taking content from somewhere else and posting it, which is perfectly acceptable to do when it's inside a classroom space under fair use laws, it would not be acceptable to do without written permission from the person that created that content if you're doing an iTunes U course that's distributed to the world. So you need to think about the copyright when you're adding your resources and your content. Make sure you have permission to use it if you're doing a global class, or that it is your content. Another thing you want to think about when you're posting videos and other content is accessibility. You want to make sure that all of your students have means of accessing this information. For example, if you're posting a video, a best practice would be to make sure that video is closed caption or you are providing a transcript for that video for students. For information about accessibility, you can go to digitalfirst.osu.edu/accessibility, and it gives you some basic information about accessibility here at Ohio State and provides you some resources and some other information. Thank you.